everyone, and welcome to the 39th annual Texas A&M Kingsville Jazz Bash. Thank you. My name is Tom Zinniger. I'm the Director of Jazz Studies here in the School of Music. This concert serves as a culmination of the fall semester work for our three big bands. So you're going to hear all three of those in the concert tonight, Jazz Band 3, Jazz Band 2, and then Jazz Band 1. So we are super excited to present some really cool music for you. We have a nice varied program. The students have worked so hard. We actually have a couple of world premieres this evening. So in addition to a lot of different genres of jazz big band music, we're also so happy to be here in our nice newly reopened performance hall. This is actually the first jazz big band concert in this hall featuring jazz in a traditional setup. The last time we played in here, we were kind of in a COVID time, so we had to set up a little bit differently. So we're excited to test out that and see how that sounds. So without further ado, our first group for the evening is Tamuk Jazz Band 3, and that is under the direction of Professor Edward Moncada. Edward is one of our own. He's an alum here at the School of Music, and he does just an amazing job with the students here. And before I bring him out, just one more reminder I was going to tell you guys. This is a jazz concert, so please feel free to clap, to yell out, to give a shout out anytime you hear something that you like. The students really like to hear that audience interaction, so feel free to lay back and enjoy yourself. So please help me welcome to the stage Professor Edward Moncada and Jazz Band 3.
Thank you. Check, check. All right. As my great mentor here used to say, if you didn't like that one, you might as well go home now. That's supposed to be funny. So that was Haitian Fight Song that comes right out of the Mingus Library. Once again, this is Jazz Band 3, and we have a really exciting program for you tonight. as I try to tell these students, and what I'm going to tell you right now is that we try to get a variety of sounds out to our listeners, and also for an experience for these musicians, try to get different styles. And if you heard us at the Texas Jazz Festival, we had a fun library as well. And that was a tough program back in October, and they had a quick turnaround for this concert here, and we did not dial down the difficulty at all. So these students are doing a great job with that. Real quick, I want to acknowledge all the people that that tune featured. That was Ryan Guetta on the bass. He's backstage now. I have my score here because I want to make sure I don't forget anybody, but I believe we have Jay first on the alto sax there. Right after Jay, we had RG on the tenor sax. Had Saul on trombone. Had Joey on the baritone saxophone. And last but not least, Dante on guitar. And hopefully you all appreciated the section features there. So that was a saxophone, trombone, and trumpet solo on that tune. So hopefully you all like that as well. This next tune is an easy samba entitled Samba Facil by Lars Hall. We hope you enjoy. Thanks. Thank you. Check, check. All right. We hope you liked that one. Once again, that was Samba Facil. That featured a few people as well. That was Matthew Gallegos on the trombone. Right after that, also on trombone, Ryan Cavazos. Then we had David Bustos on the piano. All right, so as I mentioned earlier, I did not dial down the difficulty at all for this program. And so if you will, we started off with maybe some breadsticks. We had a salad right after that, and now we're on to the ribeye. So this next tune is entitled Cruisin' for a Bluesin'. It comes out of the Maynard Ferguson Library and was popularized by a recording of that on Footpath Cafe. It's a really great album for Maynard Ferguson Orchestra, and it is known for having a killer saxophone solo. So no pressure, saxophones. But this is the last bit of talking that I'll be doing prior to this, I just want to say how grateful I am to have been working with the students this semester. I just want to take an opportunity to sing praises to this group right here because, and trying to put all bias aside, I think that this is probably the best Jazz Band 3 we've had on this campus before. If you have another idea, show me a recording, please. and it has everything to do with these students that are on stage and all the fantastic coaching that is happening all around the School of Music here. So to all the applied faculty and to all these students, thank you so much. If we could give them a round of applause, please. So Cruisin' is going to feature a number of people, and I want to list them off here real quick. So this is sort of has like a Buddy Rich flavor to it because of how much the drums are involved. So this is going to feature Andrew Knight on the drums. We're going to have Kevin on trumpet. We'll have Jay Jimenez again on alto sax. We'll have Yamila on the trumpet as well. Aristeo on the trumpet. And last but certainly not least, Adriel on tenor sax. All right, thank you so much again for coming out tonight. This is Tamuk Jazz Band 3 on Cruisin' for a Bluesin'. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. All right, one more time for Tamuk Jazz Band 3, please. All right, please stick around. We have just a quick set change, and we'll be back with Tamuk Jazz Band 2. Thanks for coming out.
How's everybody doing tonight? Yeah? All right. Hey, we got a nice crowd. Good. Got some people in the balcony. All right. Cool. So, you're one third of the way there, which means you got two thirds of a hot jazz concert still coming at you. That's the reaction we're looking for. Now, can you be louder? There we go. Just working them up for you guys. Might have gone too far. All right, so next up, this band behind me is Tamuk Jazz Band 2. And if they were at any other school, they would be Tamuk Jazz Band 1. That's how hot they are. So you're really going to like this. They are under the direction of our saxophone professor and director of jazz studies, Dr. Tom Zinninger. Thank you.
Thank you so much. You're a Josiah Torres on trumpet. And David Zamora on piano. So that opener for us is actually a special tune for me. It was actually one of the big band pieces I played back when I was a freshman in my undergrad studies, same age as a lot of these guys here. And that was always one of my favorite big band charts I played from that era in my musical career. It's actually composed by one of my former teachers, Phil DeGreg, who recently retired as a professor of jazz piano at CCM in Cincinnati, where I did my graduate studies. And it's one of those pieces that I really wanted to do with a band whenever I got a chance to direct a band of this caliber. And now I'm directing a band of this caliber. So thank you so much, guys, for indulging me. Yeah, thank you. And thanks for Phil sending the chart. So we're going to move on. Our next piece is actually, this is a world premiere arrangement. We're going to help get us all in the Christmas spirit. We're surrounded by Christmas trees here. We're going to do a piece from the Vince Guaraldi Christmas special. And this one's arranged by our lead alto player, Ben Hasso. And it's kind of, so Ben is a freshman here. He's a first-year student. And it's kind of mind-boggling for myself to be thinking about arranging big band pieces, much less of the caliber that this arrangement is. You'll hear it in a second. I didn't even think about doing big band arrangements until I was pretty much in grad school. So amazing job there. So this one's going to feature Ben on alto. It's going to feature another freshman, Joseph Sosa on trumpet. And in fact, David, you heard in the last piece, is a freshman also. So we got a lot of first-year members of this band that sound really great soloing. So without further ado, this is Skating. Shazara Torres on, I'm sorry, Joseph Sosa on trumpet. Wrong trumpet player. And on saxophone, and the arranger of the piece, Ben Hassel. Stand up, Ben. Yeah. All right, next tune up for you all tonight. We got a nice treat for you. We're going to feature our lead trombonist, who's actually been the lead in this band for several semesters now, Carlos D. Garcia. Yeah, good hand for Carlos. So this tune is one of those kind of down-home, greasy blues. It's by a great jazz pianist, Frank Mantooth. And it's kind of a riff on the St. Louis blues called Outside St. Louis. So we have a lot of fun with this piece. It lets us get down to that kind of heavy big band playing, which I think everyone enjoys. So in addition to Carlos on this piece, we're going to also feature Paul McCoy on alto saxophone, Nick Salinas on tenor saxophone, Dominic Valdez on guitar, and Leo Palma on clarinet. You can applaud for those if you want to. Yes, and we're going to open it up with Julie Lujan on bass. She's holding down. Always got to appreciate our rhythm section players. So give us a second. We'll start this piece. Please enjoy. see it. Thank you so much. That's a hot one. That's a fun one to work on. Hope the guys enjoyed that a lot. That's, to me, that's big band 101, that kind of style right there. So it brings us to the last tune in our set. And this one's a doozy, so we saved the best for last here. This tune, of course, is the great jazz masterwork by Pat Metheny, The First Circle. And this is an arrangement by Bob Kernow. And the arrangement's really cool because of actually how authentic it is to the original. And if you know anything about the Pat Metheny group and how they perform, usually there's a whole bunch of kind of extra sounds. There's often vocalists, there's like flute, certain weird kind of flutes and ethnic instruments and whatnot. And while this instrumentation stays fairly traditional big band, Bob Kernow did such an amazing job capturing all those sounds using mostly traditional big band instrumentation. You do hear some muted brass. We're gonna feature Andre, who's usually on bass trombone, on the cabasa. Yeah. Yes, yes. All right. Our sax section is going to be mostly on flutes. We're also going to feature Ben Hasso again on soprano sax this time. But this tune is, to say it's difficult is kind of an understatement. And actually what makes this tune so difficult is not really the arrangement that Kernow provided. It's pretty straightforward. What's difficult about this tune is the composition itself. A lot of Metheny's work has multimeter, and this tune is constantly multimeter. The bulk of the tune is in these alternating bars of 10/8 and 8/8, which are broken down into almost seemingly sometimes random groups of threes and twos. So it really, really, really keeps you on your toes. For the first third of the group or so, most of the band is not even playing their instruments, they're actually clapping. So that's always the most fun part to work on, right, guys? All right, so we're going to take another couple of tuning notes here, and then we'll be on Please Enjoy First Circle. Thank you so much. A&M Kingsville Jazz Band 2. Please stay tuned for Jazz Band 1 coming up just real quick.
Thank you.
to go right here, the headliners of the evening. So on stage in front of you, we have the Tamuk Jazz Band 1. So before I bring out their director and we get on with their set, I want to put a plug in for, if you saw on your way in, we have a booth or a table set out front, and we're selling a jazz CD. And this is actually not the music that is we're playing tonight, although that would be cool to get that on an album. But what we're selling actually is the first commercially available album that was actually recorded in-house right here, right up there in our recording studio. So it came with our new building here, a state-of-the-art recording studio with sound booths and a really, really nice control room and everything. And I want to give a special shout out to Vinny Barretta, who's working sound back there. You've seen him up on stage. Let's give him a big hand. Vinny does an excellent job, and he does every little thing we ask for. He just does without saying anything about it. He's just like, okay, I'll do it, sure. So Vinny's been amazing for us, both here in doing live sound and in the recording studio. So anyway, that album is actually featuring our small group, our jazz combo number one, and actually features several of the members you're seeing right here on stage. So if you would like to support the jazz program, feel free to pick up a copy. They're $10 each on your way out. If those happen to sell out, they're available. They're going to be available digitally as well. It's already available on Apple Music, I believe. Streaming is supposed to hit Spotify and iTunes, Amazon, a bunch of different things like that. So keep your eye on social media for when that goes live, hopefully in the next couple of days. So I think it's really cool we're recording actual albums now here in the School of Music. So without further ado, let's go ahead and bring on. So our last group of the evening is directed by our professor of trumpet. This is his first jazz bash conducting JB1, as we call it. So please welcome to the stage Dr. Kyle Millsap and Jazz Band 1. Thank you.
Thank you. That's Jazz Band 1. So that tune was actually written by our pianist, Joseph Hernandez. So it featured Joseph there on the keyboard and on the piano, and Frankie Chapa on tenor. All right, I'm the last one to use this thing, so I can finally set it at the right height. Did y'all having fun? This is better than waiting in a Ticketmaster queue for a Taylor Swift concert. We don't even charge you, just come all right on in. Have a seat. It's great. Cool. So we're going to keep going here. This next tune that we're going to play for you is from the Rob McConnell Library, and we won't hold it against him. He was Canadian or a valve trombonist, but he still read one of the great big bands, Rob McConnell and the Boss Brass, happened in the second half of the 20th century. This one's from about 95, but Rob was from Toronto and kind of 60s moved down to New York and started getting a name for himself, and then put together his own band in the 70s, late 70s, and everyone really wanted him to, hey, you go on tour, go on tour, go on tour, and he just didn't want to really tour with a big band, so they made a bunch of recordings, and they were widely heard and dispersed in Canada, and they really didn't get down to the U.S. until sort of the latter part of the 20th century, which is really a shame. Finally, in the 80s, he got a gig out on the West Coast, and that's when everyone really started paying a whole lot of attention to his band and what they were doing. And he's kind of like one of the great West Coast bands, even though he's New York and Toronto. But the time that they spent over there on the West Coast just had a little bit different sound than some of the bands that he grew up on the East Coast. So this one is it's kind of like if Charles Ives had written for big band instead of Rob McConnell writing for big band. That we've crammed two tunes together at the same time. We've got two bands playing at the same time. We've got two bands playing at totally different styles at the same time. Where we're going to start off with a little Dixieland combo that then gets run over by the bebop group that's going to jump in on top of them. Same changes back home in Indiana and Donna Lee. But this one's going to feature, if I can remember, because I don't have my program in front of me. It's going to be Miles. Who brought his fan club. And it's going to feature Jacob Moreno back on the trumpet. And it's going to feature some tasty drum solos by CT. So here's the next chart, Indiana/Donna Lee. All right, thank you. So that was Miles there on the sax, and we're going to have more Miles to come. So we have a tradition around here as it comes to ballads, and we don't do any, because we don't need no stinking ballads. So we're going to do a ballad, because we don't do any, so why not? So this gentleman now over here to my right was to my left, now he's to my right, when he came in as a wee young pup, fresh out of Del Rio High School, with his shiny silver alto saxophone, and he was sitting in that chair right over there that Frankie's now occupying, except it was in JB3, and I was still his director, and then he moved his way up to JB1. And so I moved my way up to JB1, so that now as Miles, Miles prepares to student teach and go away and do his last, his bit where he goes out and disappears from our nest and launches out into the world. And he's got probably one more concert with us here in about 8 days from now. So we thought we'd feature Miles on this concert, give him a nice little send-off on a ballad. And Miles told me he always wanted, despite his silver alto, to be a tenor player. He said, Miles, I got the tune for you. Because this is, despite being a trumpet player, one of my favorite big band tunes of all time. How many of you have heard of Gordon Goodwin? Okay, so before there was Gordon Goodwin, there was a guy about my height who played tenor named Bob Mintzer. And he was cooler than Gordon Goodwin, despite the fact that I have sat across from the Chili's in Kingsville, Texas, from Gordon Goodwin, and not Bob Mintzer, but I still like Bob Mintzer's charts. So we're going to feature Miles here on this lovely Bob Mintzer ballad, Lazy Day.
Thank you. Thank you.
Miles de la Garza. There, Miles, you got to be a tenor player. All right, well, our sax is getting resituated here. Moving around to the rightful positions. Bring out our conga player. Still having fun? Yeah, all right, cool. We got two more for you tonight. And we're going to pick the tempo back up a little bit. So we got a kind of a Latin number. We've got going back and forth between a couple different styles here. This next tune, I actually came across the composer of this next tune at the International Trumpet Guild Conference this past summer up in San Antonio, and saw him write a piece for a trumpet group, and so, hey, let's check out this guy, go up to his website and see what he's got, and turns out he's got some big band music. Turns out he's actually got a whole lot of awards, too. Like, he's got some downbeats for his compositions, and some concert bands, some, like, National Band Association awards, and, you know, a whole bunch of things from an aspiring young composer, which is really cool to see. So he is originally from Mexico, and has been living in, went to school at UNLV, been living in Vegas still. So gotten a chance to track down this tune that he wrote. So this is, you guys all set over there? Oh, conga's not set. We got tuned the conga. All right, so I got to come up with a joke now. I used all my best material. I used the Taylor Swift one right off the bat. The trumpet players are back there waiting for me to tell a joke too, so they got to burn it up. Oh, so this next tune is going to feature, I forgot about that, you got it in the program, but might as well. So this is going to feature our lead tenor, sorry, it says an alto in the program, it's my fault, I can't proofread my own programs apparently. Our lead tenor, Isaiah Cole. Yeah. And David De La Rosa back on the trumpet. And the reason that we've got the conga out here and making sure he gets his congas all tuned up and all set up is we also have a little solo section between our drummer back there, Christian Torres, and Knight Garcia on the congas. All right, are you all set there? All right, freshman. So the next tune we're going to play for you is, let's see how my pronunciation is, Por Ahora by Jorge Machain. I hope you like it.
One, two, three, and...
Thank you. That was Isaiah on tenor and David on trumpet, CT and Knight on percussion and drums. All right, so we've got one more for you. Then you all go home. You don't ask for any encores because I think they're tired up here. It's past their bedtime. They didn't drink enough energy drinks. Got homework to do. Still school night. We have class tomorrow. Yeah. I got to teach tomorrow, too, so I don't feel so bad for him. I got to show up at 8 o'clock, too. Yeah, so we got one more for you. And so this is going to be way back in the 60s and 70s when the big bands started really facing competition from rock bands. They said, hey, you know, those rock bands, they're all selling out the stadiums. And they're selling out the clubs, and they're selling out all the shows, and they're getting all the money. And we're not getting the money anymore, so what are we going to do about it? I know what we're going to do. We're going to play their music. So who likes Radiohead? Cool. We're not playing Radiohead. That's like the first time in a year I haven't played Radiohead on a concert. Actually, it's the first time in a year I figured out that all the students don't change meters. They're all at 4-4. And I don't know what to do up here. That's why I can just walk off stage. Now, who likes Blood, Sweat, and Tears? That's a better reaction. I like Blood, Sweat, and Tears, too. We're going to do a Blood, Sweat, and Tears tune instead. So this is Bob Kurnow, who JB2 did Bob Kurnow's arrangement of First Circle. This is Bob Kurnow's arrangement of Blood, Sweat, and Tears tune when he was writing for the Kenton Band, doing arrangements for the Kenton Band. So this is off the Kenton Play Chicago album, even though we're not playing Chicago, we're playing Blood, Sweat, and Tears, but it made the album, too. So we're going to get a little funky, little BST action going on here, and this is going to be Inner Crisis. So thank you all for coming out tonight. It's been our pleasure to play for you. Make sure that you stop by the front and check out the combo album, and if you got $10, you don't need to go home with that $10. You need to leave the $10 with us, and you need to go home with another one of the combo albums that all the students up here worked very hard to put together, and Dr. Z worked very hard getting them all coached up and ready to go. It's a great album. Joseph, who you heard on the first tune, he wrote a lot of the tunes on that, and they are not in 4-4. What'd you write it in? Like 127/32 or something? But it equates to 4-4 every 35 measures. Yeah, okay. I'm not kidding. It's like the title track. It does that. I'm pretty close. So, yeah, they worked really hard. So make sure you stop out there at the table. Leave your $10. We'll give you a combo CD. Even if you don't have a CD player, don't really care. Just leave $10, and we'll still give you the CD, and you can hang it on your wall. It's proof that CDs once existed. You can figure out some way to rip it. And you can buy the CD, and then you can buy it. That's better. Buy the CD, and then buy it on Apple Music. So we get $10 twice. And you get an actual physical copy, and you get it on your phone. Cool. So I think I've given the trumpets enough of a break here. We've got our guitar player get set up. Everyone's situated. Our bass player's got to do double duty on two different basses all at the same time. So, again, thank you all for coming out tonight. If you want more music coming to you from this stage, come out in 8 days. A week from tomorrow is our holiday concert from the School of Music. It'll feature all of the large ensembles from the university, including these guys back here, on a whole new show that we're gonna learn it tomorrow. That's why they have to come back. So this is Inner Crisis. Thank you all for coming out tonight, and hope to see you again next week.
We'll be right back.
Thank you. Texas A&M University Kingsville, Jazz Band 1. Everybody drive home safe. Have a happy Thanksgiving.